lot of what we heard from Attorney Meyer is attacking the significance of the government's interests. That's not genuinely disputed, nor was a challenge on appeal. The trial court found that the city has ongoing significant governmental interests. And so the error that occurred here is one of law and one of fact. Court applied standards under the constitutional law that does not exist. It found all three criteria to determine that these injunctions were constitutional, and then imposed an extra analysis. So to the extent that the court denied relief on constitutional grounds, that's not sustainable. That is an error. The only other way to look at this is to say, well, did the court give a valid reason to deny this just as an injunction generally? And it doesn't. There is an irreparable injury. The defendants are disputing how much the injury is, but there is an injury that has been recognized by the trial court.
What is the irreparable injury?
We fully expect that this is going to bode well and continue, and that we can't know exactly what the consequences are, but the two remaining parking enforcement officers were once three. One has quit, and part of the reason why we believe the parking enforcement officers are still there is because they've known that the court is looking at this. We don't know if they're still going to want to continue to work under these.
But isn't that, isn't there something to the fact that they, this is sort of inherent in the job? If the, if a police officer said, geez, I don't. To go back to the first example, I don't like being on the street, protecting businesses or whatever when there are angry people that are out in the street protesting. Would we say that's a reason to grant an injunction against the protesters?
Respectfully, I think Your Honor's comparison is not directly on